What is ambition? Ambition is violent. Ambition is the root of all violence. The politicians have always been stupid. This is nothing new. And they enter into politics. Otherwise, why should they enter into politics? They would have been poets or mystics or painters or musicians or simply dancers. But when a person cannot be anything and he has no talent, no intelligence, then the last possibility is that he becomes a politician. Remember, for politics, stupidity is the greatest asset. The more stupid you are, the more is your possibility of reaching to the top, because it needs arrogance and violence. It needs insensitivity, hatred, jealousy, and ambition to reach to the top of the ladder. I emphasize, the more stupid you are, the more is your possibility of reaching to the top, because it needs arrogance and violence. It needs insensitivity, hatred, jealousy, and ambition to reach to the top of the ladder. And none of these things require intelligence. Neither insensitivity, nor hatred, nor jealousy, nor ambition at all require intelligence. Otherwise, who should be interested in just becoming a ladder climber? Life has much more to give. Just sitting under a tree and playing on your flute is far more satisfying than being the president of a country. It gives you a prestige. It gives you a status. But with that, the inner fulfillment or bliss does not come. But we remain in illusion that it is the prestige, it is the status that gives us fulfillment, gives us the joy. Just being in love with a woman or a man is far more satisfying than having all the riches of the world and all the power that it can give. When Alexander came to India and conquered the frontier provinces, he was surprised to see one thing: people were so contented and so happy. He could not believe his eyes. There was such order, and there seemed to be no imposition on them. He asked the king whom he had conquered and defeated. In fact, the king was defeated because he had never prepared for war. His whole energy has been devoted to peace. It was a beautiful country, and people were happy, singing and dancing. They were all grateful to God. They had never thought that somebody was going to conquer them. As a result, there was no resistance from anyone for Alexander. People were not ready at all. They were simply surprised by the whole idea that someone had started a great movement, a struggle to conquer the whole world. Indeed, they were puzzled. For what is he going to conquer the world? Not only they, even Alexander was puzzled and surprised, seeing the peace and contentment and joy. Even when the people were defeated, there was nothing, as if nothing has happened. He continued as they were, as if nothing had happened. He asked the king, "How have you managed this order? And I do not see much military, much police, or much government machinery, and the people are living with such love and brotherhood. How have you managed?" The king replied, "It has nothing to do with me. My prime minister is a mystic. It is his work. Where is your prime minister?" The Alexander inquired as he became eager. "I would like to talk to him and learn something from him. I would like my country to be in such order and inner discipline. I have fallen in love with this Greece that I see all around. Although you are defeated, I do not see any sadness, as if I mean nothing." King replied, "But the prime minister has become a recluse now, and he has moved to the mountains. It may be difficult to find him now." But Alexander was insistent, eager, so messengers were sent, but they came back empty-handed, saying that he is not interested in showing himself off to any Alexander, to any great king and conqueror, because the very idea of conquering others is so stupid. "I am not interested in coming. You just go and tell him I do not think that he is even worthy enough to be given any advice. The politician's whole mind is nothing but ambition, full of ambition. What was it that motivated Alexander to conquer the world? The ambition, just the ambition to be considered great, to be a conqueror of the world. That is the only ambition that politicians has, and this is nothing else but ambition. It requires violence. Ambition is violent. It is ambitious. It is ambition that has made the whole earth a hell. Indeed, all ambition is violent, and this is the cause of all misery, all sadness, all unhappiness, all unfulfillment that we have in our lives. Once you understand this and you are ready to drop ambition, you will be happy, you will be contented, you will be blissful this very moment."